Welcome.
Yeah, hey, how you doing?
Good. So glad to have you with us this morning.
I'm so glad to be back. During the break, we was all talking about the KFC log.
The fried chicken log. You said you might use it depending on
who over.
Yeah.
They need to make a chitlin log. So some people, it depends on who it is.
Right. Yeah. Just a different scented log for whoever you have over
that
day.
For different types of people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's a good idea.
Yeah.
If KFC can do it, we can do it.
I'm so glad to be back in Memphis.
Hey, we're glad to have you here in Memphis. Is this going to be your first time performing at Chuckles?
No, I've been there before.
Yeah.
And I had a ball last weekend. In fact, maybe I should say this to the girl who works at the rental car place. I can still get you tickets to the show, but I brought a lady with me this time. So if you say hi, just say hi and keep moving. But I got the tickets. But
hopefully she's watching.
Oh, yeah. She'll find out.
Talk a little bit about your experience and kind of how you got involved in stand-up comedy in the first place.
Well, this is my thing. I used to be embarrassed because when you're in grammar school, high school, being the class clown ain't necessarily all that. But as you get older and you know, you make people laugh, it pays off. I can attest to that. My taxes is a little behind, but other than that, it's paying off.
Other than that, you got lots of friends.
Oh, yeah.
And you're on all kinds of stuff.
Oh, yeah. Hollywood is you know, they're a little scared of me because I'm a little edgy with my comedy style.
I was going to say, I watched one of your routines this morning before our interview. It's a little raunchy for 9 a.m.
Oh, yeah.
Just a little bit. But you'll be able to be free at Chuckles and talk about whatever you want.
Talk about all the relationship stuff.
Yeah, you talk about a lot of relationship stuff.
Yeah. Unlike Dr. Phil, Dr. Phil helps people prepare to win. I prepare you for failure because chances are it's coming. She can do better than you.
Sad reality.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Yeah. Most people are never prepared when the relationship goes bad.
Uh-huh.
If you listen to me, you know what to do.
Low standards.
That's
the way to do it.
That's right.
And then you don't get let down.
You don't get let down because you never hope for much.
Right.
That's the way to go. This is the relationship game.
Too many of us are too positive. That's our problem, I think.
Oh, yeah. Are you married?
No, I'm engaged.
Oh, okay. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
Girl. I know you're going to be engaged.
Well, it is my second engagement, so you're not necessarily wrong.
Oh,
they don't
the second
all work
engagement.
Out.
You're a player like
they
me.
They don't all work out, you know?
I'm going to give you my number for you. It might happen. Oh, go ahead.
Talk a little bit about some of the stuff that you touch on, because you're not like every other stand-up comic that I've seen.
I don't think I'm like every other stand-up
comic.
No,
you're very
different. I'm so flattered that you said that. I talk about the stuff that I think people feel like you shouldn't talk about. But one thing I've noticed, when you put stuff out there, you get it off your chest, you feel better.
Yeah.
And I'm not into the scientific part of it or whatever, but I know when I talk about my issues and when I get it off my chest, I'm transparent with people, I actually feel better.
And I feel like you say a lot of stuff that maybe a lot of us are thinking, but we don't want to say because we're like, how are people going to react to that? But you just go ahead and you just say it.
You know what? I'm telling you, the people you need to be around will appreciate your honesty.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody who has a problem with your honesty, you really don't need to be around those people.
It's true.
Especially if you're not being mean, you're just being honest.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk to you for real. So everybody out there in your relationship, start being honest if you can. Some of you guys don't mess it up because you'll be homeless if you're honest. You know if you told her the truth is over. You know.
So you believe in honesty.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I try to believe in honesty.
Yeah. Well, you're at Chuckles all weekend. Can we get the information back up on the screen so you guys can go check him out? This is all weekend, Chuckles Comedy House, obviously on Dexter Spring Loop. And there are still tickets available if people want to come out and check you out. And that girl from
the rent-a-car place
needs to get in touch with you.
Yeah, I got you. You know, I got you. Just don't talk too much.
All right.